I nearly missed this little section right here, guys. What in the world? To the left of the Van Gogh painting, you have yourself a secret room with once. Oh, but what the heck? He's got guns. Hey, guys, D-Field here, and welcome back to a brand new episode of Roblox Bloxburg. I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day today. A quick shout out to all these people hanging out right at the start of the video. We got CJ, Allie, Heavenly Queen, and there's a couple of other people here as well. Cuddly Jessica, thank you guys so much for hanging out during the intro. I've honestly been on Bloxburg like for the past couple of days just hanging out with some of you guys randomly, and the amount of times I've been getting recognized is absolutely insane. Thank you guys so much for the support. Before we go ahead and actually begin today's subscriber tour, take a quick second right now, smash that freaking like button, guys. I do appreciate all of the support you guys have been giving to my channel. If you have not yet already heard, guys, I'm currently trying to hit 300,000 subscribers by the end of the year. If you guys could help me out with my goal and hit that subscribe button as well, thank you guys so much. We welcome you into our subscriber family. And honestly, guys, there's no better place to be. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, let's go ahead and begin with today's subscriber tour, guys. We are here on Bloxburg today featuring a Victorian style mansion in the theme of autumn from my boy CJ. So once again, huge shout outs to my boy CJ for reaching out to me on Twitter and actually, you know, entering this contest. A real quick note about that, if you guys have not yet entered the autumn design contest here on Bloxburg, I'll pop up a video on the screen for you guys right now, and I'll leave a link in the description as well if you guys want more information on the autumn design contest. Every single one of you guys that enter has a chance to win a part of 10,000 Robux, whether it's a Halloween or autumn mansion, you know, house, restaurant, whatever it is. Tweet me pictures of it on Twitter. Watch that video. All the information is there. But guys, let's go ahead and actually begin this tour today of the very first winner of the autumn design contest. At the end of the video, guys, I will be giving CJ 1,000 Robux as part of the 10,000 total. And you know, honestly, there are going to be a lot more winners depending on how many designs are actually entered. So guys, the one main reason why I wanted to go ahead and actually show you guys and showcase this mansion for a Bloxburg episode is just because of the pure fact that the shape and the design of the house in itself is absolutely unique. Okay guys, now I don't know about you guys, but for me personally, whenever I think of like a British movie or like a British like mansion, I always think of a mansion sort of designed in this sense right here. Let me go ahead and boost my stats really quickly. But anyways, as I was saying, check out all of these random indentations, all of these random windows, all of these random roof spots that are just so uniquely shaped. You don't see this very often here on a Bloxburg build. The windows are basically sticking out in some sort of like symmetrical way, which just makes them pop out more and gives the house a little bit more depth of field. It's really one of the tactics that a lot of you guys need to start using a lot more, instead of just having the plain square or, you know, the plainly shaped rectangular houses, because I feel like it makes the house look a lot more expensive. So without further ado, guys, let's go ahead and enter the main house. So the first thing you guys are going to notice as soon as we stepped in is that every single room that you guys will be seeing today is literally going to be decorated in an autumn or a Halloween color style. So over here to the right side, you've got yourself your main living room. So many freaking decorations, guys. There are literally paintings and curtains and lights and just everything everywhere. I just love the fact that you guys are all starting to decorate your houses with an insane amount of decorations. It's just making the place look like an actual home. Now guys, check out all of these like orange and red and like yellow autumn hues. Oh, it's just such a good and well decorated area, guys. And seeing some of you guys just messing around with the different types of paintings and the decal codes and all of that has just been absolutely astounding, and it makes each and every single house just a little bit different, even though each house might have the same things inside it. Over here to the left side of the main entrance, you've got yourself your main office is what this looks like. Guys, I don't know about you, but me personally, whenever I get older, let's say I'm in my 30s or 40s, I'm gonna own a house that has an office just like this, where there's just like a whole bunch of bookcases behind me, maybe some like like really, really good books that I'd recommend you guys to read and stuff like that. Maybe one day I'm gonna have that in my own place. But hey guys, you never really know what could happen with life. You know what I'm saying? One of the things that I do have to mention in this room, guys, is I don't really know how to feel about the yellow wallpaper color. I feel like he is obviously trying to go for that autumn slash Halloween vibe, but yellow wallpaper just kind of looks a little bit weird. Over here past the office, we have ourselves our very first bathroom of the tour. A lot of you guys have started to utilize this sort of like marble look as, you know, the wallpaper or even the floor. I think I like it, you know? It kind of looks a lot more modern than some areas do, but at the end of the day, if it does end up turning good, you might as well just go with it. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, back to the main room over here. Let's go ahead and head into what looks like the main kitchen. Really loving these plant pots. Oh my gosh, they're just so freaking random. And for some reason, just like, look at this. This is literally in the most random spot, but it still looks so good. Here back into the main kitchen of the actual house. Once again, a custom kitchen, all marble, all granite, everything. And this section right here. Ooh, he already knows. And I'm pretty sure he's been watching some of my past videos, guys, because this is one thing I personally want to do with my next build. I want to have some sort of bar or countertop area right here where you can kind of sit down for a meal, but still have it be aesthetically pleasing. So it looks like it fits into the kitchen rather than just, you know, kind of hugging the wall the entire time. One of the things that I personally have to work with my own builds in itself. I don't know about you guys, but me personally, I think autumn is probably one of my most favorite seasons. It's not too hot. It's not too cold. I don't really have too much allergies because, you know, there's not really many flowers or stuff, you know, blooming, because in the spring, I normally get a little bit of allergies just because of all, like, you know, the flowers and stuff blooming during the springtime. But during the fall time, it's just the right amount of hot and cold. Oh, I freaking love it, dude. Over here, guys, we have ourselves our formal dining room. Every single house out there, guys, probably has like this dining room where there's like a very fancy table that no one ever eats at because it's like the fancy, you know, the fancy dining room table that no one wants to mess up, dude. Check out this painting right here. I don't know why. Guys, is it just me or do these pumpkins look so freaking HD? Like, what the heck? They're just like so orange. Like, what the heck is that, dude? Are these actually like real pumpkins? Or is this definitely, this has to be photoshopped, right, guys? Pumpkins are not like that purely orange without any imperfect. I don't know, dude. Maybe I'm going crazy over here. Jeez. Now, over here past the formal dining room, guys, you have another bathroom. You know, just a nice little chill bathroom over here where you're, you know, kind of just, you know, doing your makeup and taking a shower and all that fun stuff. To be quite honest, I feel like Bloxburg needs to add a little bit more decorations for the bathroom. But when I think about it, there's not very many decorations you can actually put into a bathroom. So I don't know about you guys, but for bathrooms in Bloxburg, I feel like they need to add a lot more items. There's just not enough variation to the things we can actually have in our bathroom. Now over here, guys, through the left door of the main entrance, you have the exit to the backyard. Guys, check out the entire design feature of this backyard. I've never actually seen this wooden design before here on a Bloxburg build, but I've definitely seen pools in real life that use like the wooden trellis thing above their pools. I'm not really sure what they're used for, but I've seen them before like everywhere. Like whether it's a hotel pool or, you know, like a pool in the backyard, there's definitely some houses in America that have like these weird wooden stuff on top of them. Do you guys really know what that's for? Like, I've never actually owned a pool or had a pool in one of my own houses. I'm really wondering what these wooden trellis things are used for in real life. I feel like you can like cover the pool, I guess, like during the winter time, you know, with them, but I'm not really sure what else they could possibly be used for. Only thing that I would probably add about this, you know, entire back door area is, you know, just, there definitely just needs to be a little bit more decorations. Now over here on the opposite side of the pool, you have yourselves a little bit of a soccer field here that all the kids can play on. Guys, I think this is one of the new autumn items. Like, I guess it's like a leaf pile that you can put in the front of your yard to make you look like, you know, you're celebrating the holidays. Oh my gosh. Back to the main room. We still need to tour the second and third floors. As you guys can see, I will probably just go ahead and walk through some of these actual rooms for you guys. I'm not going to be doing comprehensive reviews or anything like that. I'll just make a comment here and there. But hopefully you guys can find some sort of painting or some sort of, you know, decoration combination that just looks really, really good. Another bathroom over here, guys. Guys, check out the master bathroom. bedroom. This is the master bedroom on the second floor. You've got a massive bed with the autumn slash Halloween theme going on once again, guys. Got yourself a nice personal desk computer over here. Bunch of paintings, bunch of decorations. It looks so freaking nice. And then check out this walk-in closet, guys. Every single one of you guys have been starting to do this a lot more frequently over the past couple of tours I've been doing. But a lot of you guys have been using these customized paintings to make it look like I'm actually looking at a shoe rack or a closet or something along those lines. Whenever I walk into a main master closet of a bedroom, I'm always expecting to see some sort of custom painting there. CJ, very well done with those freaking, I think this is like a shoe store. It basically looks like a shoe store, right, guys? Anyways, over here, you've got yourself a nice little, you know, entertainment area with a TV and then a nice standard bathroom to go ahead and finish off the master bedroom. Now, a quick question I wanted to bring up with you guys as part of this video. So here's the bed right here, and then the TV is over there. As you guys can imagine, my bed is right here, and then over here on that side is obviously a wall that could, you know, one day have a TV on it. I want to ask this to you guys just because I have no idea whether or not to put a TV on that wall right there or put one on this back wall that you guys see me pointing to right there. So my bed is right here. I sleep going in that direction. So should I put the TV there or should I put the TV on that back wall? What do you guys think? Let me know what you guys think in the comment sections below. This TV arrangement right here literally just reminded me of it for some weird reason. Oh my gosh. Now over here, guys, the very front balcony area, as you guys can see, there's a beautiful house from the front view. Oh, just standing in front of a balcony just like this, even in real life, I feel like I just own everything that I can see. It's like, you guys ever see the, you know, the Lion King movie where he's like, everything the light touches, it's yours. Like every time I stand on a balcony, that's literally the quote that I think of. And it's just like, everything I can see in my visions, it's mine. On to the very last floor of this amazing looking mansion. You've got yourself a nice little chill area over here. He's got a computer room. What? This computer room is so nuts. The one thing that I do wish he spent just a little bit more time on is some of the paintings, guys. Some of the paintings are repeating, like this one is the same as this one. We've seen this one and this one in other places before. Guys, take a quick second with me right now. Imagine me working right here. Imagine my computer is right here, and then my YouTube team is just working right there and there, just editing all my videos, making videos for you guys on YouTube. Oh my gosh, all the different possibilities with the media room, guys. Maybe one day, all right? Maybe one day we'll have a media room in our own house as well. Over here, you've got yourself a nice little workout area, very nicely furnished. You know, most workout areas on Bloxburg tend to look exactly the same. And guys, another bathroom just to, you know, kind of fulfill the needs whenever needed. Now, one of the last rooms on the third floor of this beautiful mansion, you've got yourself another recording studio. Very nice little recording studio over here. I'm gonna play some music for my boy, CJ, right? Oh, wait, I should probably not play music because I'm gonna get copyrighted. There we go. CJ, thank you so much. This recording studio just looks absolutely phenomenal. I'm just about to do the outro of this actual video, and CJ says you missed the secret room. How the heck did I miss the secret room? Gosh dang it. I'm gonna go ahead and follow CJ over here. How did I not see this door, guys? Wait, what? How did I not see this door? It's literally right in the front of the entire house. You've got yourself an art gallery over here. Oh, what the heck? That is so trippy looking. I don't know what that is. Every time I walk towards it, that just looks so freaking crazy. You've got that. You got a colorful line over here, a bunch of autumn and colorful paintings as well. And then guys, we have a second section. What is this? What is this? Is this just like another art gallery? Oh my gosh, what is this called again? I think this is like Starry Night by Van Gogh. I nearly missed this little section right here, guys. What in the world? He's just like, D-Field, check out my secret room. Right here, guys, to the left of the Van Gogh painting, you have yourself a secret room with once, oh, what the heck? He's got guns. How many of you guys can recognize these guns because you guys play video games? And then this is the Golden Egg of Truth by Dr. Seuss. And then that's, oh, that's the Brown Rock of Justice League Circle by Andy Andy Warhol. Have you guys ever seen that before? Wow, dude, check out this freaking art gallery. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. If you guys did enjoy, make sure you guys hit that like button for me. A quick shout out once again to Callie, AM Diamond, Allie, and Blue Diamonds for being a part of the outro. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. We will see you guys again tomorrow for another Daily Roblox vid. Have a fantastic day, everybody. My name is D Field. Peace.